O positive. Before there were borders, before there were empires, before we were farmers, we were survivors. And the blood that ran through our veins was, for the most part, one type. This is type O positive. It's not just the most common blood type on Earth, flowing in nearly 4 out of every 10 people. It's the ancestral blood. It's the default setting for humanity, a biological echo from our oldest hunter-gatherer ancestors. Its power isn't in its rarity, but in its overwhelming utility. In a trauma center, O positive is the majority leader. It can be safely transfused into any patient with a positive blood type. That means type A positive, B positive, AB positive, and other O positive patients. The vast majority of the population can all receive it in a desperate moment. Blood banks don't just ask for O positive, their entire supply chain is built on its constant, reliable flow. But this ancient blood comes with a hidden evolutionary price list. On one hand, type O carriers seem to possess a strange kind of neurological armor. Studies consistently suggest they have a significantly lower risk of developing cognitive decline, including dementia and Alzheimer's, as they age. Your blood might literally be protecting your mind. But here's the trade-off. That ancestral code also left a door wide open for one of the most successful bacterial invaders in human history, Helicobacter pylori. If you're type O, this bacteria, the one responsible for the burning agony of most stomach ulcers, finds it far easier to latch onto your stomach lining than in any other blood type. It's a vulnerability written into your very cells. And that's not all. Your blood also flows differently. Type O blood has lower levels of key clotting factors. This is a spectacular advantage for your heart, dramatically lowering your risk of dying from a blood clot. But in a severe accident, that free-flowing blood can become a terrifying liability, making it much harder for doctors to stop a hemorrhage. A positive. If type O was the blood of the survivor, type A positive is the blood of the builder. This is the second most common blood type on the planet, running in about 3 out of every 10 people. It didn't emerge on the open savanna, it emerged in the first crowded settlements. It is the blood of the agricultural revolution. As humans shifted from high-protein hunting to grain-based farming, our diets and our diseases changed, and our blood adapted. The A antigen that defines this type is thought to be an evolutionary shield, offering a stronger immune response against the new diseases of civilization, the infections that festered in dense, settled populations. Medically, its high prevalence makes it a workhorse for blood banks. It's easy to find and easy to manage, as A-positive patients can safely receive blood from both A and O-positive donors. But this evolutionary bargain came at a staggering cost. That A antigen, so good at fighting off ancient plagues, is also sticky. It makes type A blood cells more prone to clumping together. This means a significantly higher baseline risk of dangerous blood clots, stroke, and heart disease compared to type O. And the vulnerability no one saw coming? It's stress. Type A individuals are biologically wired for a high alert status. Studies show they naturally produce higher baseline levels of cortisol, the body's main stress hormone. In an ancient world, this fight-or-flight readiness was a huge advantage. In the modern world, it's a chronic burden. This means that for type A, the anxieties of modern life, the deadlines, the traffic, the constant notifications, are felt more acutely, right down to a cellular level. It's a biological echo of a past that no longer exists. It's the blood of the farmer and the city dweller, resilient, adaptable, but carrying the signature of civilization and all the stress that comes with it. B positive. While types O and A dominate the globe, type B positive tells a story of movement and adaptation. Found in only about 1 in 10 people, this isn't the blood of the first survivor or the first farmer. This is the blood of the wanderer. Its genetic signature is a traveler. It has a fascinating and uneven distribution, reaching its highest frequencies in the high plains of Central Asia and the bustling populations of the Middle East. It's a biological marker that spread with the great nomadic migrations, a testament to a bloodline that thrived in the harshest, most changeable environments on Earth. This constant movement forged a unique immune system. Unlike the generalist defenses of type O, type B developed a specialist's toolkit. Its B antigens are linked to a powerful resistance against some of history's most vicious bacterial enemies. But specialization always creates a blind spot. That highly tuned immune system can be overreactive, making type B individuals more susceptible to developing long-term inflammatory and autoimmune conditions. Their body's defenses are sometimes too good at fighting. And that nomadic heritage is still visible in your metabolism. Some evidence points to type B having a different toolkit for processing carbohydrates and fats, a holdover from a diet rich in meat and fermented dairy from a pastoralist life. It's an ancient engine that can struggle with the high-sugar, processed diets of the modern world. In a hospital, its moderate compatibility means it has a decent range of donors. But because far fewer people have it, blood banks must work much harder to keep it in stock. Type B is an evolutionary fingerprint of a people who never stayed still, a blood built for a world that was always over the next horizon. But what happens when you combine the blood of the Builder A with the blood of the Wanderer B? You get the rarest positive type on Earth, a biological mystery that shouldn't even exist. AB positive. This is the paradox of human blood. AB positive is the newest, most complex, and rarest of all the positive types. It's not an ancient echo from the savannah. It's a modern biological blend, the result of type A and type B populations mixing relatively recently in human history. Its defining feature is a medical superpower. Because its red blood cells have everything, both A and B antigens, its immune system recognizes all other blood types as friendly. This makes AB positive the universal recipient. In a catastrophic emergency, they can receive red cells from any donor. ABO positive or negative, it doesn't matter. It's the ultimate biological welcome mat. But this complexity, this newness, comes with a shocking vulnerability that has nothing to do with blood transfusions. That welcoming nature also applies to its immune system. By not having to fight off A or B antigens, its defenses can be too tolerant. This leaves AB types more susceptible to certain bacterial infections, like E. coli and Salmonella. The gates, in a way, are left unguarded. Even more disturbing is the toll it can take on the mind. Multiple large-scale studies have shown that type AB individuals have a significantly higher risk of developing cognitive impairment and memory loss later in life compared to every other blood type. It's the great enigma, the most receptive blood type on Earth, but one that pays a steep and silent price for its modern complexity. We're only halfway through. We've covered the positive types, but the rarest, most critical blood types are still to come, including the one that can save everyone. If you're learning anything, hit that subscribe button right now so you won't miss the next episodes. Okay, let's get back to it. O negative. This is the hero. O negative is not common, found in less than 7% of the population. But its power isn't in its numbers, it's in its absence. Its red blood cells are blank slates. They have no A antigens, no B antigens, and crucially, no Rh factor. They are biologically anonymous. This emptiness is what makes O negative the universal donor. In the chaos of an emergency room, when a patient is bleeding out and there is no time to type their blood, O negative is the only choice. It can be given to anyone, positive or negative, without triggering a catastrophic immune reaction. Every unit of O negative in a blood bank is treated like liquid gold. It's the first blood paramedics grab, the first blood surgeons call for. It is, quite literally, the difference between life and death in the most critical moments. But for the person who has this blood, it's a dangerous condition. While they can give to everyone, they can only receive from their own tiny group, other O negative donors, and that's not their only vulnerability. Just like O positive, they are more susceptible to severe gut-shredding infections like cholera and norovirus. But the greatest risk is coded into reproduction. If an O negative mother carries an Rh positive baby, her immune system can see the baby's blood as a foreign invader. Her body can create antibodies to attack and destroy her own child's red blood cells. It is the blood of the ultimate savior, a universal gift to all of humanity, but a profound and personal risk to the one who carries it. A negative. This is the blood of scarcity. A negative is one of the rarest types found in less than 2% of the entire world's population. Its red blood cells carry the A antigen, the mark of the ancient farmer. But like O negative, it completely lacks the Rh factor. This combination creates a high-stakes medical tightrope. Because it's so uncommon, a negative blood is a precious and carefully guarded resource, but the real pressure is on the person who has it. If they ever need a transfusion, their options are dangerously limited. They can only receive blood from other A negative donors or from the universal O negative group. That's it. Their safety net is incredibly small. Like their A positive cousins, they carry the evolutionary heritage of the first agricultural societies, a strong immune defense against certain bacterial infections that plagued early civilizations. But this is overshadowed by the exact same reproductive risk that O negative faces. An A negative mother's immune system can and will attack her Rh positive baby if left unchecked. Before modern medicine, this genetic lottery had tragic consequences, turning a pregnancy into a biological battleground. To be a negative is to carry the strength of the builder, but with a constant hidden fragility, a rare and delicate balance that few people on Earth possess. B negative. This is one of the rarest blood types in the world, flowing in the veins of only about 1% of the population. This is the blood of the nomadic wanderer, combined with the extreme rarity of lacking the Rh factor. For the person who carries it, this genetic signature creates one of the most precarious medical situations imaginable. In a hospital, their donor pool is almost non-existent. They can only receive red blood cells from other B-negative donors or from the O-negative universal donor. In a major emergency, finding a compatible match is a desperate race against time. Every single B-negative donation is flagged, tracked, and protected as a high-priority, life-saving resource. Like other B-types, their evolutionary fingerprint is a map of ancient migration, but this heritage is completely overshadowed by its sheer scarcity. To have B-negative blood is to be part of a tiny, statistically microscopic fraction of humanity, carrying a biological identity that is both a unique link to a nomadic past and a profound, constant vulnerability in the modern world. But there is one blood type that makes B-negative look common, one type so vanishingly rare it pushes the very limits of human genetics. AB-negative. This is not a blood type, it's a statistical ghost. AB-negative is the rarest of all eight blood types, found in less than half of 1% of the global population. To put that in perspective, you are more than 80 times more likely to be O-positive. It is the newest blood type. It is the absolute edge of human variation. For the person who has it, their red blood cells are a fortress. They can only receive blood from other negative donors. O-negative, A-negative, B-negative, or their own tiny AB-negative group. But this incredible rarity hides one last bizarre superpower. While their red cells are the most exclusive, their plasma, the liquid gold that carries the cells, is the exact opposite. Their plasma contains no aggressive antibodies, making it universally safe. That's why they are the universal plasma donor. Their plasma can be given to any patient of any blood type, making it one of the most valuable medical resources on the planet. It is the ultimate paradox of blood, the rarest person on Earth who can receive red cells from almost no one, but who holds the unique power to save everyone. Your blood is more than just a medical file. It's a diary written by your ancestors. It tells a story of where you came from, what your ancestors survived, and the hidden strengths and vulnerabilities you carry with you every single day. Whether you are the universal donor or the universal recipient, you are a living link to an ancient, unbroken chain of survival. So, which of these eight blood types do you have? Let me know in the comments and share the one thing from this video that surprised you the most. If you love unraveling the hidden codes of our own biology, this is what we do every week. Hit that subscribe button and turn on notifications so you never miss a deep dive. And before you go, check out the video on hidden advantages of every eye color. It's on the screen right now, and it will change how you see the human eye forever. Thanks for watching.